I'm in Wilson B block. I get lost on the campus very easily. But I've managed to find Dr. Janet Sumner.
Hello.
Well, I'm very excited to be talking to you because of some unbelievable successes that the OU have been having on television recently.
Yeah, I work in the Open Broadcast Unit, which is the Open University BBC Partnership Unit. Mm-hmm. I'm the learning executive for all the science, technology and nature programmes that we do on the BBC.
Yeah.
And at the moment, the BBC are having a very big Darwin season in which the Open University are involved. And we've just had a fantastic recent success, which has really showed us that how good Open University programmes can be on the BBC at promoting the brand image of the Open University, mm-hmm. and encouraging people to kind of take their learning a little bit further beyond just watching the programme. The programme that I'm talking about is called Charles Darwin and the Tree of Life. It was presented by everybody's favourite, Sir David Attenborough.
Yes.
Went out on BBC One on the 1st of February, and it was watched by a staggering 6 million people.
I was one of those people.
I remember it well.
That means that you were one of the four people who were watching television that night were actually watching our programme on the BBC. So that's fantastic.
One in four people that were watching television were watching
David Attenborough, who is just such a legend. And I was watching that and it was flashing back to previous times of him on telly. I love that. I met him recently in Birmingham and he blew my mind. Because he's as nice in person as he appears on telly.
And you couldn't have done that programme with anybody other than Sir Dave. I do actually know him well enough to call him
Sir
Dave.
Oh, really?
No.
You got his phone number?
No, got his home address there.
Fantastic. So I didn't actually realise it was an Open University programme until the credits came up. And you could get, I believe, one of these.
Yeah, we do this on a lot of our programmes. We like to trail a print item, a really glossy, glorious print item that offers the public a chance to take their learning a bit further. So, you know, you've got wonderful pictures on the front.
The Tree of Life, yes.
On the back, there's all sorts of extra material.
Courses as well.
Plus links to our courses.
And that's a new course, Darwin and Evolution. Yeah. How's it gone?
That's S170. We were promoting it on the poster, and they had, for the first registration, they were given a target of 400 students. They are currently at, I've made some notes, 562 students, of which 98 of those are new to the Open University. So that's
You're going to have to do two courses.
Success. Yeah, well, it'll run four times a year because that's the way that short courses run. So we've just been really successful in tying together a BBC One television programme with an offer from the Open University with registrations on a course.
That's awesome.
So we're celebrating that at the moment.
How are you going to follow this?
We are going to follow it on the 5th of March with two three-part series that are going to run every Thursday. From 8 till 9, there's Jimmy Doherty in Darwin's Garden reproducing mm-hmm. Darwin's experiments, followed by from 9 to 10, Andrew Marr on Darwin's dangerous idea and about how it was used in euthanasia and eugenics. So two very strong programmes.
And I do like Marr.
Open University co-pros. And Andrew Marr, Andy, is great to work
with.
Yeah,
oh, Andy as well. Not the prettiest guy in the world, but wow, he knows what he's doing on telly.
Yeah, we're very pleased with that. They're quite, parts of them are quite dark, particularly the Andrew Marr programme, and I think they'll be dark. Very thought-provoking.
Really?
Yes. Yeah.
Awesome. I love news people doing TV as well because it gives you that sense of fact.
Yeah.
Excellent. Your enthusiasm.
You want the grand finale.
Oh, come on, there's more.
There's more. It gets even better. In October, we are co-producing on a big blockbuster blue chip natural history unit landmark called Life. It's 10 hours on BBC One. All shot in high definition. We've been filming it for 5 years.
Wow.
And it's basically an amazing new version of Life on Earth, if you like.
Oh, no way. How could you top that?
Well, I don't know. You can. Like, believe me, when you see these programmes, you can. So that's the grand finale of Darwin season.
Well, I'm excited. You're still excited. You must love your job.
I'm loving it at the moment.
Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.